morning students, here we come up with the gross anatomy lecture of the types of cecum and relations of cecum. So therefore, the types of cecum as well as relations of cecum, a very interesting topic. In the types of cecum, four different types of cecum. Now here, these types of cecum, they are often asked in MCQs or one mark question answer based on diagram only, very simple. So first type of cecum will be, if I draw here, now this will be known as asymmetrical. This cecum will be known as asymmetrical, and here this is the ileocecal junction, this is cecum, this will be ileocecal junction. So the first type of cecum, please write it as asymmetrical, or it will be known as the adult type of cecum. It is known as adult type of cecum, and it is prevalent in 90% of humans. Please note down. So this type is asymmetrical or adult type of cecum, 90%. Second, we come on this side. So here, when we draw this, it is enlarged right saccule. So this will be the enlarged right saccule here. And therefore, this cecum will be known as exaggerated cecum. Please note down, exaggerated cecum. Or in other words, the exaggerated cecum is known as, because this is enlarged, so it is called enlarged right saccule. Enlarged right saccule. These type of cecum are found in how much? 4% of human beings. So in 4%, these type of cecum, enlarged right saccule, these are known as the exaggerated cecum. Exaggerated type of cecum, and of course this is ileocecal junction. Third variety, please come on this side. The third variety will be, when I draw, this is known as the quadrate variety because it is quadrate in shape. Here the actual name of this cecum will be, it is known as infantile cecum. Please name this as infantile cecum. And based upon the shape of infantile cecum, it is called quadrate cecum. So it is quadrate variety, quadrate cecum. Infantile cecum. Third variety, it is found in approximately 3% of the human beings. And we come to the fourth. Please come on this side. The fourth one. In the fourth one, the variety will be after quadrate, that is infantile, fetal variety. And very simple, the fetal variety will be, it is conical. The fetal variety is, it is conical in shape. See here, it is conical in shape. So therefore, because it is conical in shape, it is called conical cecum. But the actual name of this conical variety is called fetal cecum. And it is found in this fetal cecum, the conical variety, it is conical in shape. It is found in 2% of human beings. So this is the fourth variety. Here we finished the various types of cecum, four different types of cecum which we have finished, all the four different types of cecum. Now appendix, we know it has different positions of appendix, 12 o'clock position, retrocecal appendix, perilial, posterior appendix, etc. We are not concerned with that. We are only concerned with the types of cecum, four different types of cecum which we have studied. First was the asymmetrical or adult type, found in 90% people. Second was exaggerated or enlarged right saccule, found in the 4%. See the shape, you can remember the shape. Third was infantile cecum or the quadrate variety, found in 3% population. And fourth was fetal type of cecum or conical variety, found in 2%. Now relations. In the relations, we start with superior relation. So if we take the help of this diagram here, superiorly the cecum will be continuous with ascending colon. So here, superior relation, ascending colon. Please note down, relations superiorly with ascending colon. Then inferiorly it will be in relation with the lateral part of inguinal ligament, the lateral part of inguinal ligament, inferiorly. Then we come across to medially, ileocecal junction, number one. So please mention medially, ileocecal junction, where the terminal part of ileum will open, number one. Number two, there will be, now here I will draw, on this side I will draw the second structure, and that will be mesoappendix, a fold of peritoneum which will be suspending the appendix. So if I draw over here, if I rub this, and then I will draw, there will be the fold of appendix. So this is mesoappendix, and where there will be the appendix which will be present. So this structure over here, this is the appendix which is suspended by mesoappendix. So medially, this is another structure, mesoappendix and appendix. So medially, first structure is ileocecal junction, second structure is the mesoappendix, the peritoneal fold which is suspending the appendix, and third structure will be, there will be a fold of peritoneum which will be covering a recess over here, and the name of that recess is the inferior ileocecal recess. So there will be the inferior ileocecal recess here, and the fold of peritoneum which will cover this inferior ileocecal recess. So therefore, this here we will write as this bloodless fold of Treves. The fold of peritoneum which covers this recess is bloodless fold of Treves, T-R-E-V-E-S. Many times it is asked in one mark question answer, bloodless fold of Treves covering the inferior ileocecal recess. So it will cover the inferior ileocecal recess. So this is many times asked in MCQs or one mark question answer. So medially, the cecum is related with three structures. What are those three structures? Very easy to remember based on diagram. Number one, ileocecal junction. Number two, mesoappendix with the appendix. And number three, the bloodless fold of Treves, there is a fold of peritoneum which will cover the inferior ileocecal recess. So superior relations, inferior relations, medial relations, now anterior. Anteriorly, the entire cecum is covered by skin and coils of ileum. So the skin and the coils of ileum will cover the anterior relation. Also, there will be inferior margin of greater omentum. The inferior margin of greater omentum will cover the cecum from anterior side. Now comes the most important, posterior relations. Posterior relations, the most important will be, here I will draw the structures that will be posterior to it. So please draw the structures. Posterior relation, the first structure, ileopsoas muscle. So please draw in this way, the psoas major and iliacus, and we will mention here posteriorly. So posteriorly I will start mentioning from here. Please mark here, I am going to write from this side. Posterior relations, the first structure is iliopsoas muscle. Second structure is the fascia iliaca, which will cover the iliopsoas muscle. Remember, these are the posterior relations of cecum. Very simple. Fascia iliaca covering the iliopsoas muscle. Third structure. There are various nerves which are located beneath the fascia iliaca. So deep to fascia iliaca, there are various nerves. And those nerves which we draw, very simple. Here we will draw the trunk of femoral nerve. So therefore, we are going to write here femoral nerve, trunk of femoral nerve. Next nerve which we are going to draw will be the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. So here we are going to draw this as and write it down as lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. The fifth nerve, the fifth structure, there is a third nerve, and the fifth structure will be genitofemoral nerve. So please mark here genitofemoral nerve. Remember, these are the structures present on the posterior side of the cecum. Iliopsoas muscle covered by fascia iliaca. Beneath the fascia iliaca, you find the femoral nerve, then the lateral femoral cutaneous nerve, and genitofemoral nerve. So, these are the structures that are related posterior to the cecum. Along with that, there will be the genitofemoral nerve also, and the various other nerves, femoral nerve, lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. Similarly, the iliopsoas muscle, which is covered by fascia iliaca. And the last structure will be retrocecal recess. And sometimes, along with the retrocecal recess, you will find retrocecal appendix also. So, retrocecal recess here, we can mark the retrocecal recess in this way. This is the fold of retrocecal recess, and we can mark here this is the retrocecal recess, which is present just posterior to the cecum, where you may find the retrocecal arrangement of or 12 o'clock arrangement of appendix. So these six structures, they are related with the posterior surface of the cecum. Very important. So here we finish the types of cecum and relations of cecum. Thank you very much.